Hello everyone, welcome to this video lecture of Irrigation Engineering. This is Sukamal Ghosh, Assistant Professor, Civil Engineering Department, Greater Kolkata College of Engineering and Management, JAS Group. In this particular video, we are going to discuss about lining of canal and the economical justification of canal lining. So, next to China, India has the largest area under irrigation. The irrigated area is constantly and continuously being increased so as to ensure the assured irrigation and to avoid crop failures due to famine or non-availability of water. To secure the benefits of irrigation land, a tremendous amount of capital has been invested in our country in the irrigation projects. And since the investment is very large, the irrigation water is very costly commodity, and as such, there should be no wastage during its carriage from the reservoir to the fields. Most of the canals which are constructed in India to carry the irrigation water are unlined, and hence a large part of this costly irrigation water is lost in the percolation and the absorption as seepage loss. It has been estimated that 25 to 50% of this irrigation water is lost due to seepage. So, the lining of canal or the canal lining is very important. Now, what is this canal lining? See, by canal lining, we mean the earthen surface of the channel is lined with a stable, means the inerodible or impermeable lining surface, such as concrete, tiles, asphalt, etc. Okay? It has been seen that due to the lining of the canal, the losses due to seepage can be reduced from 2% to 5% of their original values of unlined canal. So, we can understand that what is the importance of lining of canal in our country. Okay? Now lining may broadly classified into three categories: the rigid lining, the flexible lining, and the lining in combination of membrane in the bed of the channel and the brick or concrete on the sides of the channel. It means, suppose this is the channel, okay? So, the combination lining means we will provide the membrane on the bed of the channel. See, this is the bed of the channel. And we have provide membranes, okay? We have provide membrane in the bed of the channel. And on the side of the channel, these are the sides of the channel, right? On the sides of the channel, we provide concrete or maybe, you know, brick or tiles, okay? So, this is called combination lining, okay? Now, this classification is according to IS 10430-2000, okay? So, this particular classification is according to Indian standard 10430-2000. You can classify the lining in different ways, okay, such as the exposed or hard surface lining, then the buried membrane dry lining, and the earth surface lining, okay. Now there may be several types of rigid lining, such as stone pitch lining, the burnt clay tile or brick lining, the precast cement concrete or stone slab lining, the in situ cement lime or concrete lining, the stone masonry lining, the soil cement lining, the shotcrete lining, the asphaltic cement or concrete lining, okay. Now, there may also be several types of flexible linings, such as geomembrane, okay. This geomembrane are, you know, this HDPE means the high density polyethylene, then the PVC means the polyvinyl chloride, then LDPE means the low density polyethylene, okay. Apart from that, the bituminous material can also be used as flexible lining. Then the fiber reinforced plastic tissue as folic membrane. Then the composite membrane or the rubber lining. These materials can be used as flexible lining. And as we discussed about this combination lining, that we can use these membranes in the bed of the channel and the concrete or brick or tile on the sides of the channel. Okay. Now we are going to discuss about the requirements or the needs of lining. So the first and foremost requirement of lining is economy. See, the type of lining selected should not only be economical in initial costs, but also in repair and maintenance in the long run. Apart from that, the structural stability, then strength and durability. See, actually the canal lining shall be able to withstand the effect of velocity of water, rain, sunshine, frost, freezing and thawing where it is applicable, then the temperature, moisture change, chemical action of salts, etc. Okay. Then the repairability and the easy maintenance. See, the unlined canal is very prone to silting and scoring. That is why the maintenance is pretty much required in unlined canal. So by lining the canal, we need to reduce this maintenance part. Okay. Then the maximum hydraulic efficiency. In unlined canal, the rugosity coefficient is higher, and that is why the hydraulic efficiency is less. Okay. Then the impermeability, as we discussed in the very beginning of this particular lecture, that if we line the canal with the impermeable surface such as concrete or tiles or bricks or membranes, then the seepage loss will be reduced. Then the resistance to erosion. Okay, as we discussed in our earlier lectures, that in unlined canal, due to the higher velocity of water, the scoring occurs, right? The scoring takes place. So if you provide lining in the canal, then it will resist that scoring. Okay. Then ability to prevent the weed growth. Okay. See, in the unlined canal, since the surface is made of soil, the weed can be grown, the weed can be grown in the bed of the canal, and that is why again we need to maintain that. But in the lining of the canal, this problem reduced. Okay. Then the resistance against the burrowing animal, then the reasonable flexibility. Okay. Now, so in the very beginning of this particular lecture, we have discussed to reduce the seepage loss, we should line the canals. Now, apart from this seepage control, there are several benefits or advantages of canal lining, such as prevention of waterlogging, then the low operation and maintenance cost. Moreover, the increased hydraulic efficiency, then the reduction in cross-sectional area, also the increased in commanded area and miscellaneous. Okay. So now we will discuss the advantages or the benefits of canal lining elaborately. So we have already discussed this seepage control aspect, right? We have discussed that the seepage losses are considerably reduced if the channels are lined. The seepage losses can be reduced to 2 to 5% of their original values by lining the canals. Okay. Now it should also kept in mind that heavy seepage losses in canal make the requirement of construction of large reservoir and bigger dams. So prevention of seepage by lining would therefore reduce the impounding capacity and hence lower the construction cost of the works. Okay. Now the next advantage or benefit of lining is prevention of waterlogging. See, the uncontrolled seepage through unlined canals often raises the water table in the surrounding fields up to or near to the ground level as to bring the crop roots within the capillary fringe. This in turn brings the alkali salts near to the ground surface, which soon renders land unfit for the cultivation. Okay. Such a land usually called thur. Okay. This type of land which are not fit for this cultivation is called as thur. And the phenomena of rise of the water table is known as water logging. Okay. Now, if we provide the lining, then it will prevent the seepage and thus protect the cultivated land. So, the combined with the land drainage schemes, the lining helps to reclaim the waterlogged areas. Okay. Now, next advantage or benefit of lining is reduction in operation and maintenance cost. Okay. See, on account of the high velocity in the line canal, the problem of silting is pretty much less, or you can say the problem of silting doesn't occur in the line canal. So, there is no requirement of periodical removal of the silts. Okay. Now, a huge amount of money is spent in removing the weeds from the unlined canal. Now, lining eliminates or reduces this expenditure considerably. Okay. Because the plants flow down the canal due to the higher flow velocities in the line canal. Now, periodical pluggings of hole borrowed by the rats, insects, etc. is constantly required in unlined canals, failing which breaches the channel embankment may occur. Okay. Now, the provision of adequate lining reduces the danger of these breaches, and hence lesser vigilance is required. Okay. So, there is no requirement of minor repairs like plugging holes borrowed by the rats and insects. Okay. Now, since the value of rugosity coefficient is very low in the line canal due to the smooth surface of the line canal, the velocity of flow in the line canal is high. Okay. See, this is the Kutters equation. In this particular equation, you may observe that if the value of rugosity coefficient, that is capital N, decreases, then the velocity of flow, that is V, increases, right? Hence, in the line canal where the rugosity coefficient value is very low, the velocity of flow is high. And since we know that discharge Q is equals to AV, so due to the higher velocity, that is higher V, the value of discharge will also be higher. That is why in line channel, the velocity of flow and the discharge is higher. Okay. So, you may observe in this particular table for different types of lining, the different values of rugosity coefficient, that is capital N. Okay. Now, our next advantage of lining is reduction in cross-sectional area. Due to the higher velocity of flow in the line canal, the greater discharge can pass through the smaller cross-section. Okay. See, we know that Q is equals to AV, right? So, from here you can write that A is equals to Q divided by V. Now, since in the line canal the value of velocity of flow is higher, so the area will be lesser. That is why in a line canal a greater discharge can pass through a smaller cross section. Okay. Now, our next advantage is increase in commanded area. See, a line canal can be designed not only smaller in cross section but also shorter in length. The steeper gradient can be provided because the higher velocities are permissible due to hard lining material, and that is why a shorter element can therefore be selected. Okay. Now, on the other hand, a flatter bed slope can be provided without silting on the line canal compared to this and unlined canal. Therefore, it helps to bring high area under the command. Okay. Now, there are several miscellaneous advantages of lining, such as prevent in weed growth. We have discussed it already, right? Line canal also increase the resistance to erosion or abrasion because the lining material is hard. Apart from that, it provides a stable channel section which is easier to operate. Okay. Last but not the least, in a line canal, the water loss due to evaporation is very less due to the higher velocity of flow in the line canal. Okay. Now, though canal lining has so many advantages, but still it has certain disadvantages, such as the lining of irrigation canal involves the high initial investments, means the high initial cost. Apart from that, it is very difficult to repair the damaged lining. Now, since the lining is permanent, it is very difficult to shift the outlet if it is necessary. Okay. Now we are going to discuss about the economical justification of canal lining. In certain cases, the lining of canal may be required from purely technical considerations. For example, a canal constructed on a high field or a canal founded partly on rocks and partly on permeable strata may be unsafe unless it is lined. Sometimes a hard lined surface may be required to withstand the high flow velocities, such as in power canals. Apart from these circumstances, the engineer is required to produce a good economical justification for the capital outlay that is likely to be invested on the canal lining. In considering the economy of canal lining, it is necessary to evaluate the tangible additional benefits and then to compare this with the cost of the canal lining. So, a lining of canal will be economically justified if the extra cost of providing the canal lining is less or equal to the value of the benefits resulting from the lined canal. Okay, so we need to calculate the total cost of the construction and the maintenance of the lined canal annually, and also we need to calculate the benefit that we can get from the lined canal annually, and then we need to compare both the values and to justify the economical benefit of the lined canal. It means if the extra cost that is required to provide the canal lining is less or equal to the value of the benefit that we can get from the canal, or you can say lined canal, then it is economically justified. Okay, so let's discuss. So as we discussed in our last slide, for economical justification of canal lining, first we should calculate the total cost to construct and to maintain the lining of the canal annually. So the total annual cost of lining is C by Y plus C by 2 into R by 100, where the C is the capital expenditure or the capital cost required to construct the lining. Now this Y is the lifespan of the lining in years, okay, and the R is the rate of annual simple interest in percent. Okay, now how can we get this particular expression? See, if this C is the capital expenditure required on lining or the capital cost required for construction of lining, and this Y is the lifespan, means the total lifespan of the lining, then the annual depreciation charge is C by Y. Okay, and if the rate of annual simple interest is R, then the average annual interest cost can be given by C by 2 into R by 100. Okay, now if you add this two term, then you will have the annual cost or the annual total cost for the lining. Okay, now we will calculate the total annual benefit that we may get by providing the lining. Suppose irrigation water is sold to the cultivators at a rate of R1 per cubic, and reduction in seepage loss due to lining is M, means this M amount of water is saved by lining. Then the total money saved by lining is M into R1. And if the P is the percentage fraction of the savings achieved in the maintenance cost by lining of the channel, and R2 is the average cost of annual upkeep of the line channel, then the maintenance cost reduced is P into R2. Okay, it is so simple. And if you add this two term, then you will have the total annual benefit. Okay, thus we can write that the total annual benefit is m into r1 plus p into r2. Okay, generally the value of this small p is taken as 0.4. okay, now so we have derived the expression for the annual benefit and the annual cost. Now we need to calculate the benefit to cost ratio, and the benefit to cost ratio can be given by this particular expression. See, the expression for the annual benefit is m into r1 plus p into r2, and the expression for the annual cost is c by y plus c by 2 into r by 100. So using this particular expression, we can calculate the benefit to cost ratio. Now after the calculation of benefit to cost ratio, we need to analyze that whether it is justified to provide the canal lining or not. So if the benefit to cost ratio is equal or greater than 1, then the lining of canal should be done. It means if the benefit to cost ratio is greater or equal to 1, then we may provide the lining. But if the benefit to cost ratio is less than 1, then the lining will not provide any kind of economical benefit. Means if the benefit to cost ratio is less than 1, then it is not justified to provide the lining. Okay, so to provide the lining, the benefit to cost ratio must have to a value more than 1. Okay, now we are going to solve a numerical on economical justification of canal lining. So the problem says a unlined canal which is giving a seepage loss of 3.3 cumex per million square meters of weighted area is proposed to be lined with 10 centimeter thick cement concrete lining, which costs rupees 180 per square meter. Now the problem has been asked to use this following data and work out the economics of lining and the benefit cost ratio. So the data given is annual revenue per cumec of water from all crops is 3.5 lakhs. The discharge in the canal is 83.5 cumecs. The area of the canal is 40.8 square meter. The weighted perimeter of the channel is 18.8 meters. The weighted perimeter of the lining will be 18.5 meter. The annual maintenance cost of the line channel per 10 square meter is rupees 1. And if we need more data, we need to assume those data. The problem has asked this. Okay, now let us consider 1 kilometer reach of the canal. Okay, so if we consider 1 kilometer reach of the canal, then the weighted surface per kilometer is 18.8 into 1600, which is equal to 18,800 meter square. Okay, now we need to calculate the annual benefits. Okay, we have discussed that how can we calculate the annual benefits. So our first benefit that we will get by the reduction in seepage loss. So the seepage loss in the unlined canal has been given is 3.3 cumecs per million square meter. It means the total seepage loss is 3.3 into the total weighted surface per kilometer, which is we have calculated, that is 18,800 meter square. So if you solve it, you will have this 62040 divided by 10 to the power 6 cumex per kilometer. Okay, now we assume the seepage loss in channel at 0.01 cumec per million square meter of weighted perimeter, then we will have the total seepage loss in line canal is 0.01 into 10 to the power 6 into the weighted surface. Okay, so if you solve it, you will have the, let me clear it, you will have 188 divided by 10 to the power 6 cumex per kilometer. Okay, now, so what will be the net saving? The net saving will be 62040 divided by 10 to the power 6 minus 188 divided by 10 to the power 6. So if you solve it, you will have 61852 divided by 10 to the power 6 cumex per kilometer. Okay. Now the annual revenue saved per kilometer of the channel is the net saving multiplying the 3.52 lakhs, which will equal to 21,648. Okay. Now we will calculate the savings in maintenance cost due to the lining. So the annual maintenance cost of unlined canal for 10 square meter is rupees 1, which is given in the problem. Now the total weighted perimeter per 1 kilometer length is 18,800 square meter. So the annual maintenance charge for unlined channel per kilometer is 1880. Okay, now, so let us assume that 40% of the annual maintenance cost can be saved by providing the lining. Okay, so the annual saving in maintenance charge is 40% of the annual maintenance cost, that is 1880. So if you solve it, you will have 752 rupees. Okay, now the total annual benefit per kilometer will be 21,648 rupees plus the 752 rupees. Okay, and if you add these two digits, you will have 22,400. This 21,648 rupees has been saved due to reduction in seepage loss, right? We have calculated it earlier, right? Now we will calculate the annual costs. Okay, so the area of lining per kilometer of channel is 18.5 into 1000, which is equals to 18,500 square meter. Okay, now the cost of lining per kilometer of the channel is 180 rupees per 10 square meter. It has been given in the problem. So the total cost of lining is 3,33,000 rupees. Okay, now if we assume the total lifespan of this lining is 40 years, then the depreciation cost per year is 3,33,000 divided by 40, means the C by Y value. Okay, this C is this 3,33,000 and the Y is 40. Okay, now if we assume the rate of interest is 5, means this 5 is the R value. Okay, okay, let me clear this. Okay, so this 5 is nothing but the R. Okay, so the average annual interest, we have derived this expression, right? So if you put all the values, we will have the 8,325. Okay, so the total annual cost will be 8,325 plus 8,325. Okay, because these two values are same, this value and this value are same. We know that the total annual cost is C by Y plus C by 2 into R by 100, right? So this C by Y value is also 8,325 rupees, and this C by 2 into R by 100 is also this 8,325. Okay, so if you add these two digits, you will have 16,000 650 rupees. Okay. Now we are going to calculate the benefit to cost ratio. See, we have already calculated the annual benefit and also we have calculated the annual cost. So if we divide the annual benefit with the annual cost, then we will have the benefit to cost ratio. So if we divide the annual benefit with the annual cost, then we will have 1.35. So the benefit to cost ratio is 1.35. And we have already discussed that if the benefit to cost ratio is greater or equals to 1, then we may provide the lining of the canal. It means if the benefit to cost ratio is greater or equals to 1, then it will be economically beneficial to provide the lining. See, in addition to this benefits discussed, which is the water saving and the reduction in maintenance cost, there may be some other benefits. We have discussed, right, that there are some other benefits like prevention of water logging, reduced cost of drainage for adjoining lands, reduced risk of breaching, reduced chance of malaria and other diseases in dump areas. But the actual evolution of these benefits is very difficult and may be approximated, okay, based on the experience. And they may be taken into account for evaluating the annual benefit cost ratio, but for the time being, for the proper calculation of this benefit to cost ratio, these two benefits, that is water saving and the reduction in maintenance cost, can be taken. Okay, so this is all about the economics of lining. In the next lecture, we will discuss that how can we design the line channel. Till then, stay safe and stay happy. Thank you.